HelloRoyTunes.com. So we are doing the design of a fire sprinkler system. The last lesson we finished a wet fire sprinkler system, and this will be a dry fire protection system. First I want to show a little bit more about the wet system. So remember when we started here, we used the auto route tool that gives us the option to, from this menu, we add all these sprinklers and then the pipe, the software suggests one route. Now let's do it differently, but quickly. So let's say first I will add all these sprinklers to the system. So we touch any of the components that the existing system. Now we have the piping system option. We could hit edit, we could hit add. I could do a window and select everything, since it's looking for only sprinkler right now, is the only components that we have in this project that works with these commands for a piping system. So I could say finish, and to test it I could hit tab 3 times, 1, 2, 3, and it's telling me all these sprinklers now are part of it. I hope also does, but the window, it tells you you grab the whole thing. So if I look in on assignment, on assigned piping sprinklers, there is no on assigned. All are assigned to the wet system number one. Now, in the past we said we create this connector, and then by touching this, I use the generate layout. Now I'm not gonna use that. And let's assume you know more as an engineer, so you don't need a suggestion. So I'm going to right click on the connector, draw a pipe, zoom out with the wheel. I haven't clicked anywhere. I hit the tab, but the long space bar, I think it's called space bar, but I call it tab, the long tab, but I want to call it space bar. That's the correct name. So I apologize for been calling tab or long key from the keyboard or whatever. Now I want to create, when I hit the space bar, it choose the same pipe as this and the same height. So I want to keep it up to probably this point, and I'm going to escape, and now probably from the middle another one. And no, actually not from the middle, from the end. And because I already hit a space bar, I know for sure we are using the same size of pipe. Now I'm going to open this connector and right click on the connector, draw a pipe command and space bar, and okay, so I have those mains. Now in my project I still haven't do any calculation, so the software suggests like that one 6 inches, this one still 6 inches, now that one half an inch, and this one still 6 inches. So if you see it's not designed yet, but this suggesting is smaller at the end. Now I want to do a branch. Let's say I'm going to drag this to the middle and right click, draw a pipe, and instead of 6 inches, I hit space, so it selects 6 inches and 9 foot, but now I'm gonna say only 2 inches branch. One there, and obviously I have a stair here, so I cannot put one there, but let's put just 2 right now, just to show quickly this other command. Now If I hit it, I put my mouse and hit the tab, the rear tab, not the spacebar, three times. It's connected to the system because I started from this connector, and also this should be part of the system. I maybe because my screen is too small, but tab. Okay, so it's part of the system. Now let's touch one of these branches and look for. You could do things like add insulation, add a slope, or ignore a slope to connect. All these commands that right now I'm not gonna touch. At some point, I will do a special lesson for that kind of thing. Now I go to the tool that we know, edit system. Actually, that's not the tool I'm looking for. I'm looking for. I was touching the pipe, but I should touch the sprinkler for the tool I was looking for. So I touched the sprinkler, so I got the option of layout again. But instead of using layout, I'm gonna use connect to. So I say connect to this pipe, and it will create a connection. Now I select another one and layout and connect to and connect to, and probably this one will create some conflict here, so I say connect to. So because I knew it was going to create a conflict because the position, probably I would do this. I open the connector, I say draw a pipe. Maybe 2 inches is too much, half an inch, and look for the connector. Look when I found the connector, it highlighted and say enter. So that's basically one by one. What happened if I just go? If you see the hidden blue line, that means I'm parallel. So I could click on my main when I'm parallel, the space bar, and it's gonna grab the same size. But I'm gonna change it instead of 2 inches, half an inch. Then look for the connector here, and I assume my memory is trying to find it. Let me see to this side because maybe I wasn't aligning. So if I click, I want to see in 3D. I don't think it grabbed the connector because I didn't see it highlighted. So in order to grab the connector, probably because it was not aligned, I want to escape this. Say draw a pipe. Okay, I could do it this way. I'm gonna delete this. I'm moving accidentally something. So I touch the connector, draw a pipe. I'm gonna leave it here open. Right now it's not. I forgot to hit the space bar, so right click, draw a pipe, space bar. Wanna leave it here because I forgot to remove this piece that previously I put it here. Okay, now I see my connector there and I have my connector here. I will look for that connector and it's not aligned. That's part of the problem. If I start from there and hit space bar, I'm not trying to touch the other one, so I leave it on the side, and the reason is because I'm gonna, by leaving those two pieces in a gap, I could align it, align to this one, that one, and say disconnect. Now I could connect it. Oh, the reason is it's in different height, that's why it's creating all this problem. I will say select previous to show what my problem is. The problem is it was a difference in height. That's why I was having problems. But okay, so now it's connected. So that's what I was trying to do. So it was just a quick thing that I want to show another way to do what we did, and everything from the previous steps is good. Also, this is good, so you choose your way. It's just matter to practice. The important thing is to know which commands exist and start using it. So now I will switch to the dry system. So before I start the wet system, no, the dry system, I want to remind you, in YouTube I will not put the whole series, but if you go to my website revitoons.com, click on tutorials, then another window will come, RabbitMonster. Click on free tutorials. Over here you will see some of my samples. All this stuff is mine. But if you click on free tutorials, you will see the last four tutorials that I have, the last three that I have uploaded. So to watch it, you could hear, you could click anywhere here where it says click to see all or click one of these. Either way, when you click, it brings you to this place where you have to log in, put your name and your password. But if you don't have a login name and password yet because you are new, a new user below, type your first name, your last name, your email, and submit, and you will get name and password. And then you come back, click free tutorials again, and come back here, and then you put your username and password, and it will bring you to the window where the tutorials are. And when you are in that window, you select if you want architectural, structural, mechanical, or Revit families. And so far I don't have everything yet, but as the time continues, I will incorporate more and more until we die. RevitToons.com. So let's go back to this dry system. Now let's explain why we use a dry system. Wet system is this because always we'll have water, and dry system will have a valve and separate this room. So this portion will be always dry until this valve opens and water comes and spring the room in case of fire. But it keeps all the time empty those pipes unless it's a fire. And the reason is because it could be a computer room or any equipment that is in danger if there is water overhead. So that's why they call it dry system. That is controlled by a valve right here. So these two rooms, I don't remember what is the other one, but I will look in a minute. These two rooms that will have a dry system. And I think it's this room and this room. Anyways, but I know one is the server room. So according to this exercise, we are going to do it from this sprinkler. So first select the sprinkler. Make sure you select the sprinkler, not the pipe. You see, it tells you right here that I select the pipe. So it's selecting a pipe going down. So I'm going to hit tab, 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 tab. Okay. I hit select tab several times until I need to select just the sprinkler. Maybe I use my window, and because I select more than one object, I could go to filter. I don't want no pipes. I don't want fitting. I want only the sprinkler. Okay, that's the best way to. Now it tells me right here you select a sprinkler. That's what I want to do right now. So first of all, I'm going to switch to a reflective ceiling because I want to see the grid. Earlier I was working on floor plan, but I need to see the grid, so I'm switching to the reflective ceiling fire protection sub-discipline. Like, remember, when I don't select any object, I could see the properties of this view is a ceiling, and the main discipline is mechanical, and the sub-discipline right here, sub-discipline is gonna be fire protection. This is mechanical, see, fire pro sub-discipline, fire protection. So, okay, that's why it's organized together here. So again, I'm going to select the sprinkler only, remove everything else. And what this exercise is saying, make two copies here. So I use the copy command, multiple, because I want two. And I'm going to use as a reference one corner, so that way I could perfectly say, look how I could jump from place to place. But I'm using intersection here and intersection here, good enough. So I create a copy. Now I will select both. Notice that is obviously at the same height as the one as I copy, and this now I'm going to change the type right here. You see the height is hosted on the ceiling. So now we are going to ch change to dry pendant hosted, and it will be half an inch. This. Dry pendant hosted. Okay, yeah, that's the right one. I'm gonna say disconnect. Now, if we keep both selected, remember, because our brand new, they don't have assignment right here. That means they don't have a system yet. So right now it just tells you what type of sprinkler is, and because it's that type, when I have it selected and I look for the create system button, it will give me the option. In this case also, those particular families color sprinkler dry system has only one option, so I choose the existing option and say okay. So now I have two systems. One is the dry system and the other one the wet system. And I wanna have only piping. And if you see pipe system, you have two, fire protection dry and fire protection wet one. And the dry is also one. Okay. And as you know, when you select here, you could also see it here. And remember, if this thing, this system browser is off, let me go to analyze. If that is not visible, you have to go to analyze tab and hit system browser. Let me show you. And as you always know, you could switch options here. In this case, I want to see systems and only piping, and I remove everything else so it's not too much of a big list here. And auto adjust the dimension of, not the dimension, but the size of these columns, and we are good now. Now, one more small trick. Remember, by putting your mouse on top of any of the element and hitting tab 1, 2, 3 times, 3 times, you could select the whole system, which goes red here. Now, if I put it here and hit tab, also I could select that system. Now, the other trick is, The whole system, when you select it here, it also will highlight here. So in this case, dry system, notice that it also highlights here. And where is wet system here? If I select it here, it also highlights here. So it's both ways. If I do it here, it highlights in the other side, and if I select it in the system browser, it also highlights on the screen of the plan view, the ceiling view in this case. Now on these tabs in home, we are going to click on type and pipe. When we have pipe, we have this option. I'm going to escape. So normally we look like this. The last object that we select is the properties we see. So in this case, I don't touch any object, so it tells me properties of this view. Now I'm in home. When I hit pipe, it comes this command, the properties, so it allows me to choose which pipe type. So I'm going to use dry. So now it's ready to be used. And by default, we have diameter 2 and 9 foot offset from the floor. Remember, we did some settings before. And this button, which is automatic connect, it needs to be on. Automatic connect. The other one is justification. I'm not gonna click around on that one right now. Let's do it simple. And remember, because we want this pipe to be always dry, it needs a slope. So let's choose a slope. And depending on what direction you are going to draw it, so I'm going to draw it from the connector, so slope up. And we are going to put 1/8 of an inch in 1 foot. What happened here? Slope. 1/8 of an inch in 1 foot. So I have my slope set, slope up. So I'm going to draw a pipe from this branch right here. And I'm going perpendicular. So I could see the blue line right there, the hidden line. That means I'm right perpendicular from the sprinkler. I already click once, hit the space bar, don't connect it yet. Click it to where the other intersection will be. It's just like SketchUp, and I click there. And then to the other one, and I'm gonna zoom with my wheel. When I see the connector highlights, then I click. So I'm going to connect this. So I get a warning because I'm connected at a dry system to a wet system. So at some point we will change to a valve this T that we have. So we could correct that error that we have right now. Also, let's go to 3D. Remember, we can't connect this. The reason I didn't connect because I want the complete slope. So if I touch this, it will have a slope all the way from here to there. So let's go to the 3D. And I'm going to touch the architectural model, hide element, and I'm going to see my floor plan so I could select in 3D. I could see what are we talking about here. So it's this room. So if you see this big symbol, slope 1/8, and then I touch the other one, slope 1/8 also, and this sprinkler hasn't connected yet, so I highlight it. I look for my command that, remember, I show you right here, connect to, and I touch the pipe. Again, it's gonna tell me this is a dry system, and this pipe is connected right now to a wet system. For now, we ignore it. We just need to add a certain bulb here. So for now, let's stop this video so it doesn't get too big. So we have the wet system, dry system, and now we are going to modify the diameters. So revitunes.com, and also I forgot to mention, when you sign up, also you have the option to click on Revit Book right here. It's a forum where you could ask me question, and I will try to respond as much as I have time. And you have to, unfortunately, you have to create your login and password because so many hackers. So this is separate password from the videos and separate users, so you have to register again. And that's because so many hackers attacked those forums, so I had to create a more sophisticated system for that. Also, you have the option to, on this button, post a job if you have a job offer. Also, it's for free. You could use the same password as the videos and tutorials. And also, you could post your resume. And what else? Very soon, you could also expose your own tutorials if you want to advertise your business or yourself. And also, you will be able to expose your demo reel as a professional. I will have a tab here, demo reel, from users, so everybody could use an space to put something like this demo reels that I have of myself. It will be another page specific for all the users that want to do that. Revitunes.com and Revit Monster, obviously, same thing. Thank you. This is Gamelli.